All right, just dropping into the Clary Ross channel after a long absence of about 5+ months. I said on the channel that I would post updates when additional clarity came, and so far nothing significant has come. The basic outlines that I've given have remained the same, but I felt it was important to at least just give a general update on what's going on without any, you know, significant changes to what's been said before. I stand by everything that's been said before. My purpose here was to validate what other people are feeling and intuiting, which is that there's a need for preparation, that there is a problem, there is a barrier coming up. We're about to run into a barrier. And so I just wanted to add my two cents that what I have seen is, yes, that this is valid. There's been a lot of attempts to debunk the Mayan prophecy of 2012 recently in the news. But I would say that the 2012 prophecy is a very valid one as far as the quote-unquote end of the world is concerned. And that people should not be abandoning this and thinking everything's going to be fine. It's not. I mean, we're 5 months into 2012, and maybe some are saying, hey, nothing's happened, everything is fine. But the seeds, again, of trouble are very obvious. The red flags are very, very obvious. We have 7 more months to go in this year. And I would say the people should stick to their guns, stick to preparation. However they see that preparation. My preparation, as I've said before on this site, is to find a way to sidestep all the troubles. Now others are trying to find a way to ride out the troubles. There's also two spiritual perspectives that we find. One is to try to dissolve the barrier that we're going to run into, and the other is to sidestep the whole situation. As I call it, relocation. That's what I have been focusing on over at my other channel, Christ Clarity, is working out the specifics of relocation. How is it possible? How can it be done? How can we free ourselves from our quote-unquote karma here? It's very important. How can we let go? How can we move forward and get free past the guilt, you know, the quote-unquote survival guilt? Very important. There are many things that bind us to this world, and none of those binds are legitimate, really, none at all. So I've been clarifying that over at Christ Clarity Channel. So we're taping this live here, live upload to YouTube, so no pauses. I might have to clear my throat sometime. So I would say that my best guesstimate is 5 months and 5 weeks into 2012, something is going to happen. But I don't have any specific information. Giving exact time frames is extremely difficult. I had a couple of very accurate predictions last year, and including the one was in early November, I think. But after that, I said I could not really pinpoint exactly when, you know, severe troubles will take place. I wasn't really sure of it. Excuse me. So at this time, also, I don't have exact time frame. It's too difficult. But I would say this year, 2012, in the 7 months that are left in 2012, it's very, very likely that we will see the Earth beginning to feel the effects of this barrier and coming up upon a dead end. Earth is really what I saw, is the Earth is coming up to a dead end. The Mayans said it's the end of the world, so to speak. Well, what does this mean exactly? Well, it certainly means trouble. And it's certainly something that many have foreseen. I'm just one voice out of many who have picked up on this and have always had an innate ability to foresee the future and been accurate so many times. And This is what I have seen, that there is a real barrier we're coming up against, and there will be a financial crash before that. But that's, you know, that's just part of the effects of running into this barrier. It's as if this cycle, this long cycle that the world has been going through, is abruptly comes to an end. It's not a slow thing. It's very abrupt. And so, not wanting to be a fearmonger in any way, I only want to give people hope that there's some way that this can be sidestepped. One does not have to be a sacrificial victim, so to speak, in this scenario. Now, everybody is going to prepare in different ways. And whatever preparation people have done, they're ahead of the game. And some will, you know, try to sidestep it by finding retreats on this planet. And maybe some hold out some hope that they'll be able to relocate to other planets, other dwelling places. Some will hunker down where they are and try to ride out whatever takes place that way. And there's a lot of variations. And you know, I'm not saying one is better than the other. It all depends on what I call one's karma, so to speak. Karma means how one has been forgetting one's true identity, the various ways it means one has been using to forget one's identity. And so we all have employed various ways and means to do that, because our identity is not body or flesh, it's spirit. And spirit is not vulnerable at all. It's invulnerable. So this whole scenario of vulnerability is a way for spirit to forget what it is, because it wants to be something greater than what it is. It wants to be prime creator. Therefore, it has to try and forget what it is. Otherwise, it would know that it can't be prime creator. So we're in this vast cosmic dream of many dimensions, many levels, incredibly sophisticated, complex, and intertwined. It's all a dream. It's all a dream of forgetfulness of what we are. So at this time, in this world, in this place, we are all using various ways and means to distract ourselves from remembering what we are. And each one of us will have employ different ways and means. And some want to remember what they are. So they don't need these ways and means. They don't need catastrophe. They don't need all these severe distractions that the world will supply here. And therefore, for them, the option of just sidestepping the whole thing, not even going through it. It's, let's say there's a huge accident on a freeway, and somebody has a GPS, and it shows on the GPS, you know, huge accident ahead, you know, use alternate route to get around it. And someone with that GPS will then take an exit ramp off the freeway and maybe use side streets and just bypass the entire thing. Whereas others without that warning, GPS warning, will be snarled in this horrible, horrible traffic jam. Like, for instance, on freeway Interstate 5 in California, sometimes there's tule fog, this incredibly severe fog that you literally can't see past your bumper. And when one person stops, for some reason, something happens, and a pileups happen because nobody can see the brake lights even. And you have these massive, massive pileups that are, you know, just take day to disentangle. You know, the whole freeway gets shut down. So if one has an advance warning, let's say one is going south on Interstate 5 before Bakersfield, and they get a GPS warning that up ahead on the Grapevine, there's been this huge, you know, pileup. They say take an alternate route, and they can get off and go up towards Barstow or something, take an alternative route and get around it and not have to, you know, go through that nightmare. So sidestepping it is like that. It's getting advanced warning and then taking an alternative route, so to speak. This is a very good analogy to use. It's pretty simple. Now, for those who don't get the warning or don't want to take an alternate route, they're going to get, you know, stopped and be sitting in their cars for a long time. And they might want hope that they have some food in their car, some food and some drink and some blankets and all those things to try to ride out this mess as it tries to get disentangled. And, you know, nightfall will come and it's very cold and dark and it's just horrible. but some will, you know, want to write it out that way. So these are variations that are coming up, and certainly there are I would say about half of the world believes that something, we're going to hit a barrier. The other half believes we're not. I'd say it's really pretty much divided on this planet right now. So those who believe that, yeah, there is, we're going to hit some barrier, yeah, it's about 50% of the world actually, you know, believe this. So it's not a strange position to take at all. It's not a minority opinion, it's not a majority opinion. So, but it's a very, very substantial opinion. And for those who see it that way, they see the red flags. So many red flags. I believe it's, you know, the Spain-Portugal situation is the one that will bring it down. But, you know, others view, you know, the Greek situation. Others have different ideas. I believe it, you know, it's a combination of factors. But the Spanish problem will be the straw that breaks the camel's back, and because there's a lot of rottenness in the financial system. There's missing money. There's trillions of dollars of missing money. It's hedged in so many different ways that it's out of control. But that's just part of a bigger scenario. It's a bigger situation than just a financial collapse. Now the question about sidestepping it is if it's possible, will we be made welcome? And I did see this. I saw myself sidestepping it, going somewhere else, and I asked, am I welcome here? And they said, absolutely, absolutely, 100%. You're like our sister world or something, you know. We know about sister cities, right? That was very popular, maybe still is, that, you know, San Francisco have a sister city, and maybe in Japan or something, and various cities have sister cities in different parts of the world. Well, maybe this planet has a sister planet. You ever thought about that? It's interesting that scientists are now saying that they're discovering more and more planets like Earth, and they say, you know what? There's probably, it's the rule rather than the exception. There may be billions, billions and billions of them throughout the cosmos. So it's more than highly likely that there are other dwelling places. Cosmos is very big. Not only that, that there are other dimensions, it's also very, very complex. And we cannot rule out the possibility of sidestepping the situation. And like I said, I am very confident that we would be made very welcome somewhere, because I had this experience. When I had the experience of seeing the financial collapse and the problems in the world, I saw myself going to another place. And I arrived there, and I said, is it okay if I stay here? I said, and I explained the situation back in the world. I said, it was, you know, it's really terrible. And they said, yeah, we know about that. We know about that. They said, absolutely, you're very welcome here. Stay as long as you want. Our place is your place. So the complete welcome mat was rolled out, and I felt entirely comfortable. I also experienced that it was a, you know, extraordinarily beautiful place. So I've always kept that in mind, that it may be possible. Now, there are various traditions that talk about relocation. In the Bible, it certainly talks about it. It couches it in the story of Jesus, and saying that, you know, at the end times, a time of catastrophes, Jesus would return and would somehow lift the people off of this planet that want to leave and take them to some place that he has prepared. That's the basic theme of it. And that has been believed for a long time. But there are also many others who talk about ascension, about evacuating the planet, and all these types of things. So there's a common thread there. And sometimes where there's smoke, there's fire. Now, I don't have any specific information at this time beyond what I've already gotten about any details about this. I really do not. And maybe it's a blessing in disguise, because what's happened over the last 5 months is I've spent my time prepping, doing my preparation, intense preparation. In other words, taking my own advice. I said to everyone, you have to go into intense preparation right now. And so, you know, I had to do that too. I had to do that too. And I've gone into intense clarification, intense satsang. I'm giving Christ Clarity satsang over at Christ Clarity Channel on YouTube, and giving in very, very intense, very long videos of helping clarify very deep levels of resistance and reluctance and confusion, which I believe is very beneficial. So that's my way of prepping, and I'm sure others have been prepping in their way, and it should be continued. It absolutely should be continued, but we are very far along now. I believe the last 5 months have been a time of grace, where we've been able to really do everything that we need to do, clean out stuff, whatever it is that we felt is very important for us to do. I had a goal to be done by Memorial Day, and I reached it. Just the day before, I was able to complete a huge amount of projects that I've been working on. So now my time is free to put somewhere else. Now, I don't know, maybe some additional clarification will come. Like I said, I have had a lack of clarification, which may have enabled me to focus on this preparation that I've been doing. Otherwise, maybe I would have been posting here a whole lot and, you know, following the news too closely and using my time in an unwise manner. And perhaps coming up, there will be some clarifications I'll be able to post here. I've had some requests for that, asking if I have any updates in any additional timelines and that kind of thing. But, you know, basically 2012 is it. I mean, this is the time where everyone needs to bear down in their lives. It's like giving birth. You have to bear down. There's a time of pregnancy, and then there's a time when you give birth and have to bear down. At that time, you really have to bear down and give it everything that you've got. So what you need to birth is, you need to birth your clarity. You need to free yourself from guilt. Free yourself from the ego. Free yourself from the massive web of lies and distortions that keep people entrapped. Keep them in a belief in sacrifice. Keep them in a belief in distraction. Keep them bound to a belief that what they are is this body, and that this world is their home. If they're a body, then of course they're going to believe this world is their home also. The ego is born of a lie. It's a born liar. That's all that it does. And it lies very, very cleverly. And it's very important to make very significant into seeing past those lies. Because I believe one of the big lies is that we have to somehow stay here on this planet. I believe that's a lie. The belief that we have no way to sidestep what's coming, I believe that's a lie. Okay, I believe we do have a way to sidestep what's coming. And if our intent, our will, is put there, that this then will pave the road to doing that. And I've had several dreams of showing that I was able to sidestep the situation. It requires a kind of a certain type of willingness, a certain type of confidence. I saw that, you know, things are going to get very, very difficult here. And we're going to feel sort of knocked off track. And that tends to lead to passivity and confusion. People kind of milling around, not knowing what to do. You know, kind of people are stunned, shocked. You know, when the financial system collapses, people are going to be in shock and not know what to do. And they just sort of feel like sitting in one place and giving up. But those who have prepared for this, you know, they'll keep driving their car. You know, they'll just say, okay, just keep right on trucking. This is all expected, and now we expect there's going to be a way to sidestep this, and let's take that off ramp and get on and take the side streets and maybe hit a new freeway like that. And it won't be difficult. I know that throughout history we've had a lot of warnings. A lot in the scriptures, the Bible, it gives a lot of warnings. Of how important it is to be prepared, to be ready. vigilant, to not be seduced by the bread and circuses of this world. The song and dance that is being constantly produced now. And I admonish everybody to find what is most profound for them and to focus on that and avoid the trivial, the frivolous. Because there's so much of that. That's like the ostrich putting their head in the sand. Don't be the ostrich. I don't know if that's true or not, but there is a tendency. I've also spoken about the whole sacrificial mindset, that there's a, when one is preparing for sacrifice in history, there have been many human sacrifice cults in history, and when one is preparing for sacrifice, they get the one to be sacrificed, they put him in a drug state, trance state, they give all this entertainment and dance and drugs, etc., and they prepare them for this. And it seems like to me, on a global scale, the world is being prepared that way. Through all the songs and dances, just everything that is being spoon-fed to us through the vast media entertainment Frankenstein monster that is continuously flooding the planet with unending distractions, that people are almost like drugging themselves with this. Not almost, they are drugging themselves with this. Preparing themselves for sacrifice. I mean, for me, it's just the opposite. I absolutely avoid all of that. And I have for a long, long time. Because I realize, no, one has to be very, very sharp and full of clarity for these times. Very vigilant. Very much focused on the fundamental truths. And what I have said is that the fundamental truth is that all of this is a dream that mind is presenting to spirit, that spirit wanted to be prime creator. And so it has to forget what it is, what it really is, which is that which is the was created by the prime creator. It has to try and forget that, and it has to not remember what it is in order to maintain this pretense that it can be prime creator, that maybe it is prime creator. It's all a pretense. It's a pretending. And so distraction, severe distraction is necessary. Severe forgetfulness is necessary. And what is forgetfulness? Well, vulnerability. Vulnerability. Fragmentation. That is distraction. That gets it keeps spirit in a deep state of forgetfulness, because it, as it views modification, fragmentation, vulnerability, destruction, all of that, it forgets what it is, because none of that is possible in reality. None of that. Reality can't be fragmented, it can't be harmed, it can't be destroyed in any way. Life cannot harm life. Life cannot even threaten life in any way. So this cosmos and the events keep spirit distracted from turning towards remembrance of what it really is. And the events that are about to take place in this world are a massive distraction. Massive distraction. And the ego is telling everybody this is good for it. It's very necessary. Because if we don't, the ego says, if we don't keep ourselves distracted from remembering what we are, if we turn towards remembrance of what we are, we'll be annihilated. Because what we are has been annihilated. That's what the ego tells us. That's a lie. Okay? Complete, total lie. We don't need distraction. Maybe what we need to do is diminish the amount of distraction that we use. Keep diminishing it instead of increasing it. What the ego is going to do is increase the amount of distraction in this world, meaning destruction, confusion, chaos, mayhem. Increase it and exponentially until it peaks. And it's telling everyone that this is a great opportunity to stay here and go through that. And why? Because this will bring about, you know, deep, continuous, very, very deep forgetfulness of what one is, so that the pretense that we're prime creator can be continued. So the ego is doing its job, because we want to try and experience being prime creator. That's the kind of clarification I give over at Christ Clarity Channel. And this is what I absolutely believe was what's been shown to me very clearly. And that's the basis of sidestepping this whole scenario that's coming up, the end of the world scenario. We don't need the distraction. It's just that simple. We don't need that level of distraction. Period. When I go past an accident on the freeway, I don't look. I don't look. I don't need that distraction. You know, rubberneckers. You know, I was driving recently and there was this huge slowdown. I said, oh my gosh, it must be a bad accident. Well, it wasn't. It was just something on the side of the road. Someone hit the center divide or something, but it wasn't blocking the road at all. But everybody was slowing down to look at it. You know, instead of just saying, come on, everything's fine, let's move on. So, I don't need to be a rubbernecker. Maybe you don't need to either. We don't need to rubberneck this world. What's happening in this world, we don't need to be rubberneckers here. Don't need it. The lie of the ego is that if we turn towards remembrance of what we are, we'll be annihilated. But there's nothing there. It's not true. Not true at all. The ego does not understand what we are, which is that which cannot be modified. The ego takes that which cannot be modified and says it's nothing. Because the ego believes that life is modification, fragmentation, constant modification, impermanence. That's what the ego believes is life. So it tries to look at spirit and it doesn't see any of that taking place. So it says, well, there's nothing there. That's it's a perspective, and it's a false perspective. Totally false perspective. So the ego tells us we need to rubberneck. It's very important for us to all be rubberneckers here and drink in as much of this fragmentation and problems on this planet as possible. And the voice of reason says, no, that's not true. You don't need to be rubberneckers. You don't need to look at that distraction. In fact, you may not need to look at any distraction at all. But some may need a little bit of distraction. That's okay. But the real effort is to lessen it. And this planet here is going to go through a severe distraction, severe modifications. And so all you have to ask yourself is, is that what you want? You can check in with your spirit and ask yourself as spirit, saying, do I really want to be immersed in distraction, severe distraction? Of course this existence is severe distraction in itself. But you can put some icing on that cake and make it even more severe. And that what that will do will engross you in another cycle of existence. Really, this is the ending of a cycle. At the ending of a great cycle, you have the option to continue on with another cycle or to actually free oneself from the cycles of existence, from the cosmic dream. To wake up from that cosmic dream. To experience the perfect stillness is just present, that present as this isness, to experience that instead of all the impermanence and modifications. We have that option. So at the end of this cycle, which we're right at it right now, next 7 months, we'll tell the tale. We definitely need to check in and decide which way we want to go. Do we really want to be enmeshed in another cycle of impermanence? Another cycle of forgetfulness, another cycle of distraction? Or do we decide, you know what, there's got to be a better way. I want to drop my distraction. I want to move towards letting go of the distraction. I want to move towards remembrance of what I really am. And that should give rise to a wonderful option. As I call it, sidestepping, relocation, something like along those lines. I don't believe that we are destined to... We don't have to suffer through the troubles here. Really do not. But one should prepare and bear down during these times. So hopefully that's what's been taking place over the last 5 months and over the last year. And as I said, I don't have a specific timing, but maybe it'll come. If it comes, I said I'll post it here. But I just haven't had that take place. And I don't want to try and manufacture it. I can only guesstimate at what's going on. But next 7 months, look out. And don't worry too much about details of what's taking place here. That's not that important. Focus on your decision of what level of distraction do you really want. Because there are those here on this planet that crave an enormous level of distraction. And the reason why they've come to this planet, think about this, is because they know that there's going to be massive distraction here. Massive. That's why they've come here. And you could just watch the trailers for various movies right now and see the mayhem in those movies and the people going to see those, and they're craving it. Those people crave massive distraction. They incarnated on this planet because they knew it's coming. I incarnated on this planet because I knew it was coming. I wanted to warn people that there was an option to sidestep it. I don't crave those types of distractions, those massive distraction like that. Don't crave it at all. I don't play video games. I don't go to movies. I don't do any of that stuff, and I don't miss it one bit. But there's been a huge, huge influx into this planet of spirit, aspects of spirit, that have an enormous craving for severe, severe, intense distraction, intense destruction, appetites for destruction. And the warnings have been coming for a long time that this severe destruction will come here. 100 years ago, the Titanic sank. And in what, April of 1912, that was a warning. Big, big warning. The Titanic was sailing along 22 plus knots an hour, and you know, pitch black night in the ice field, and captain was very confident. Hit an iceberg. What did it do? Hit a barrier, right? The iceberg symbolized a barrier. Titanic symbolized the world. The world is going to hit a barrier. What happened? The Titanic sank. The unsinkable ship sank. So there are many people in this world that are very confident that nothing can happen in this world. The world cannot come to an end. It's impossible. Well, many, the world thought Titanic could never sink. It would be impossible for that to happen. Especially with such an experienced captain at the helm. You know, it just was not possible. So many wealthy people were on the Titanic. But it sank, and it sank fast, and there wasn't enough lifeboats. But 700 plus people were able to, quote unquote, relocate to another ship, right? Another ship came to the rescue and relocated those in the lifeboats. That's an analogy. That was a warning. It was a symbolic precursor. It was some kind of echo bounce from the future back into the past to warn us about what to expect. So it's been 100 years now. It's the 100 years warning. So there's some kind of barrier out in time and space that we are going to run into, so to speak. I don't know what exactly the nature of it, but unexpected and rapidly situations will collapse here on this planet. And I expect that some will be safe from that. Some will choose to relocate to a safe situation. And it has to do with one's karma. Karma, again, means the level of distraction that one desires, which is dependent on how much one wants to continue to try and to pretend to be prime creator. When one repents or gives up the desire to be prime creator to some extent, then their karma is greatly lessened because they don't need so much distraction that keeps them from remembering what they really are. And karma actually can be completely dropped altogether, meaning one decides to choose a new idea and not try to be prime creator. And that means remember what one really is. And for those, sidestepping be a piece of cake. No trouble whatsoever. So remember the Titanic analogy before anyone gets too arrogant and says, nothing can go wrong here. Too many people, too many visionaries, too many intuitives have spoken out saying that there's a real likelihood of troubles coming up. Too many red flags are popping up. So keep your nerve. Keep your nerve. Don't panic. Don't get frantic. Just get focused and say, how can I prepare? What's the best way to prepare? And what level of distraction do I really, really need? And can I not turn towards the path of repentance, which means to choose a new idea, which means to give up trying to pretend to be prime creator? That's all that it means. Just realize that it's futile, that really you're not interested in it that much anymore. And decide, you know what? I don't really need all the distraction of destruction. I don't really have an appetite for destruction. Maybe, you know, minor, little bit. We all have a little bit. That's normal, but we don't have to amplify it. We can turn away from that. That's the basic message that I've been trying to give here on this channel and over at Christ Clarity. We can turn away from that. And certainly my hope that everyone will turn away from that. Nobody needs it. Nobody really needs it, because what the ego says that we'll be annihilated if we don't remain distracted from remembering what we are is a lie. It's a lie for everyone. It's not a lie for some and true for others. It's not. No, it's a lie for everyone. Everyone's spirit is perfectly intact, perfectly untouched, immaculate, perfectly functional. Everyone's. It's just some are in deep forgetfulness of this, and others are starting to remember this is true. That's the only difference. And those who want to have an appetite for destruction and want to rubberneck here in this world and soak it all in, well, that just means that they'll remain in forgetfulness of what they are for a little while longer. That's all that it means. They're not lost. There's no such thing as lost spirit. No destruction of spirit ever can take place. That's another lie of the ego. It simply means that those who want to put themselves through the, you know, massive troubles, they just want to remain pretending to be prime creator for a little longer. And they will for a little longer, maybe another cycle. But they'll eventually get tired of it, they'll get bored of it, and they will then repent. They'll turn towards choosing a new idea and choosing not to be prime, try to pretend to be prime creator. Very simple. Really, existence is very simple. It's not complex. Not in the slightest bit complex. It's completely flat, really. It has the illusion of depth, illusion of complexity. Cosmic dream is actually completely flat. There's nothing really there. It's just a pretense. And pretense is actually flat, isn't it? But pretending to do the impossible, that's flat. We're not really experiencing it. We're pretending to experience all of this. So, I hope that I'll have some more updates here. I hope that we can get some clarity on what's going to happen in the next 7 months. I mean, I don't need to say the obvious. I mean, obviously, the Euro crisis is there and the Mideast crisis is there, and there are other situations brewing too. That's all obvious. And unintended situations will certainly can arise. And everyone already knows this, just stating the obvious. So everybody, stay focused on your spirit and the truth. The truth is that you are spirit, you're invulnerable, and you merely have forgotten what you are. That's it. And there is a way to remember what you are. Very simple. And just contemplate how much distraction you really want. Just ask yourself that and start to go in the direction of less distractions. I really don't need much distraction. I need to start focusing in on that path. And then don't worry. Don't worry. Everything will be fine. Fine for you. According to your karma. Okay. Very great. That's it for now.